It is recording, yes. Then what I should show? Lecture. Okay. So what we were discussing about the first stage BOD formulation. So in the first stage BOD formulation, at a given temperature, the rate at which BOD is satisfied at any time may be assumed to be directly proportional to the amount of organic matter present in a sewage. It is directly proportional to the amount of organic matter present in a sewage. Okay, so therefore we can express in a mathematical form by writing the equation dLT upon dt is equal to minus k dash into LT. Okay, so this is the BOD formulation equation. So please write down first stage BOD formulation. At a given temperature, the rate at which BOD is satisfied at any time may be assumed to be directly proportional to the amount of organic matter present in sewage. Mathematically, we can write the equation. Write down this equation: dLT upon dt is equal to minus k dash into LT. Okay. So where LT is the amount of first stage BOD remaining in the sample at any time t, and it can be expressed in a milligram per liter. What is the LT? Note down. LT is the amount of first stage BOD remaining in the sample at any time t, and it can be expressed in a milligram per liter. Then what is k dash? It is the rate constant, or we can say it is a deoxygenation rate constant. If it is used, the k dash, it can be say that it is a deoxygenation rate constant to the base E. And if only k is used, in that case we can say deoxygenation rate constant to the base 10. Okay, so what is the relation between k dash and k? That I will show you further. Then t is the time in a days. Okay, when we will integrate that equation number one, that is dLT upon dt is equal to minus k dash into dt, when we will integrate in between the t is equal to 0 to time t is equal to t, in that case what happens, you can see integration of dLT upon dt is equal to minus k dash into integration of dt, or we may write this equation log to the base e, LT upon L naught is equal to minus k dash into t. Is it? We have integrated it. T is equal to 0 to t is equal to t. Or we may write this equation in another form, that is LT upon L naught is equal to e raised to minus k dash into t. Or LT upon L naught, we can write in on one more way, that is LT upon L naught is equal to 10 raised to minus k into t. So what is the k dash? K dash is nothing but the deoxygenation rate constant to the base E, and k is the deoxygenation rate constant to the base 10. Okay, that we have discussed in our earlier slide. So please write down this integration, and then we'll go to the next point. Integrating equation between time t is equal to 0 to time t is equal to t. Therefore, integration of dLT upon LT is equal to minus k dash into integration of dt or log to the base E LT upon L naught is equal to minus k dash into t. Or you may write this equation LT upon L naught is equal to e raised to minus k dash into t. what is LT and what is L naught. LT, amount of organic matter present in a sewage at any time T. L naught is the amount of organic matter present in a sewage at the beginning of the, at the beginning, is it? And K dash and K is the rate constant to the base E and to the base 10 respectively. Okay. In the last form, LT upon L naught is equal to 10 raised to minus K into T. So hope you have noted down this exam, this step. Now we will go to the next point. Where rate constant, I told you, the relation between K and K dash, we need to maintain. What is the relation between the K and K dash? K is the rate constant to the base 10 and K dash is the rate constant to the base E. So what is the relation between that? K and K dash, K is equal to K dash upon 2.303. K is equal to K dash upon 2.303. Okay, and where L naught is the oxygen equivalent of organic matter present in sewage at the beginning that I told you just now. Okay, have you noted down the relation between K and K dash? K is equal to K dash upon 2.303. Okay, we'll go to the next point. The amount of BOD remaining at any time T is, the amount of BOD remaining at any time T is, any time T म्हटलं की काय होतं की BOD remaining at any time T म्हटलं की काय होतं की LT. So that LT equation is nothing but L naught into the bracket 10 raised to minus K into T. Okay. Hence YT is the amount of BOD that has been entered, exerted at any time T, and that can be given by, with one more expression that we will see. So time being, note down this, the amount of BOD. So you may note down this equation in this lecture, in the next lecture, in a fast I can explain you. So whatever you understanding through this way, you understand. In the next lecture, once again, I will explain you. Okay. The amount of BOD remaining at any time T is equal to L naught into the bracket 10 raised to minus KD. And YT, another terminology, YT is nothing but the amount of BOD that has been exerted, that has been exerted at any time T. Shall I move to the forward? If you have noted down, we will go to the next point. Okay. Time until now, what is it? Amount of BOD. LT is organic matter. Amount of organic matter. And YT indicate the amount of BOD that has been exerted at any time T. And it is given by YT is equal to L naught minus LT. Okay? That equation exert karto. Exert karto manje kaya hota ki BOD tumcha organic matter ale ale kiti hota ani kai tharavik vela nanta te kiti rahila. काय करतं एक्झर्ट करतो म्हणजे काय की एखाद्या स्ट्रीम मध्ये तुम्ही डिझॉल्व वेस्ट वॉटर सोडताय तर त्या बिगिनिंगला डिझॉल्व ऑर्गेनिक मॅटर किती होतं दॅट इज नथिंग बट द एल नॉट आणि ठराविक टाइम पास झाल्यानंतर म्हणजेच ऍट एल टी ला ते ऑर्गेनिक मॅटर किती आहे ऍब्सोल्युटली ऑर्गेनिक मॅटर कमी होणार एल नॉट पासून एल टी पर्यंत का कमी होणार तर त्याच्यामध्ये असलेला मायक्रो ऑर्गॅनिझम इट विल डिकम्पोज द ऑर्गेनिक मॅटर and it will reduce the organic matter present into that wastewater, is it? So from that you can determine the YT as the BOD at L naught as well as at LT. So that exertion is nothing but YT is equal to L naught minus LT is equal to, so again the value of LT we have calculated in the equation number 3 or 4 somewhere, and that we have seen that LT is nothing but L naught into 10 raised to minus KT, or L naught LT is equal to L naught into E raised to minus K dash into T. So here we have taken only one, that is base to the base 10. Value of LT is to the base 10. So L naught minus value of LT we will put, and the value of LT is nothing but the L naught into 10 raised to minus KT. Okay. Then further, when you solve this derivation, you will get L naught into bracket 1 minus 10 raised to minus KT. Okay, that is the formula for YT. YT is equal to L naught into bracket 1 minus 10 raised to minus KT. Ata T kaay tar T is the time in a days. Ata YT, samjha mala Y5 kaadaycha asel, tar mi tar T kiti ghenar? 5 ghenar. Ita mala samjha Y12 kaadaycha asel, tar mi tar T kiti ghenar? 12 ghenar. Kiwa Y.5 kaadaycha asel, Y.5 kaadaycha asel, tar mi tar T kiti ghenar? 0.5. Getting? So that equation we have derived for the YT is equal to L naught into bracket 1 minus 10 raised to minus KT. YT is the BOD at a T days, or we can say BOD T is equal to YTT. Okay, so write down this equation. Okay, shall I move to the next one? Okay, YT is the BOD at T days. So BOD 5. That's why I said that if I have BOD 5, then how do I modify the equation? Y5 is equal to... This is not right, sir. This is right. I don't know this is right. Y5 is equal to... L naught minus L5. L naught the constant is run array current BOD at the organic matter present at the start and after 5 day, after 3 day, after 7 day, after 20 day, whatever will be there, that is the difference. Accordingly, you can write down the BOD 10, BOD 5, BOD 2, BOD 12, whatever is there. Is it? So, BOD 5 is equal to Y5 is equal to L naught minus L5 because we are finding the BOD 5. Again, equation we can rewrite in the form of L naught into bracket 1 minus 10 raised to minus 5k. Ata hai kasala 10 raised to minus 5k. Ita kaya equation apla? YT is equal to L naught into 1 minus 10 raised to minus k into T. Ha T manja kaya ki? Hazar Y5 asel tar ha T5 asel. Hazar Y10 asel tar ha T10 asel. K into 10 asel. Okay. So on this same principle, you are finding Y5, so it becomes a L naught is equal to 1 minus 10 raised to minus 5k. Okay, now ultimate BOD. We will see the equation for the ultimate BOD. Ultimate BOD, we can give the notation YU. U for ultimate will be obtained by substituting the T is equal to infinity. Why ultimate BOD kadacha selter? We need to substitute the value of T as a time is equal to infinite time in equation number 7. And then we can solve it. Thus, YU is equal to L naught into bracket 1 minus 10 raised to minus K into infinity. Thus, ita pan 5 ghetla hota. Thus, ita time kya ghetla hai? Infinite time ghetla hai. So, the equation is written as YU is equal to L naught into bracket 1 minus 10 raised to minus K into infinity. 10 raised to minus infinity. It becomes a 1. 1 minus 1, it becomes a, sorry, yeah, 10 raised to minus infinity ka value 0. So 1 minus 0, it becomes a 1. So 1 we are not going to consider. YU is equal to only L naught is remained. Manjas kai sala ki tumcha ultimate BOD is nothing but the L naught. Ultimate BOD manjas kai salta L naught. What is the L naught? L naught is the amount of organic matter present at the beginning. Ultimate BOD. So you should remember all these relations to solve the further examples. Okay. So while solving examples, you will understand what are the why this equation has been derived for the first stage formulation. Okay, shall we start these examples? If before that you note down this slide, and then we will start small examples today, and one or two example at actual which is going to be asked for the exam. Note down this slide, please. Okay, shall we go to the next point? All right. Okay, examples. I will take the examples. So I will stop this file and I will share another file with you. Is it visible to you? Write down the example now. Please write down example. Then I will explain. It is very simple examples taken at the start. Simple examples you can take. 5 ml of raw sewage was diluted by specially prepared water in a 300 ml capacity BOD bottle. In a 300 ml capacity BOD bottle, the DO concentration of diluted sample at the beginning of taste was 9 milligram per liter and 6 milligram per liter after 5 days. Incubation at 20 degrees Celsius. Find the BOD of raw sewage. Okay, for better understanding, once again I will read. 5 ml of raw sewage was diluted and that raw sewage cha BOD kadala sangitlay tumhala last sentence madhe bro, diluted by specially prepared water. Ata hi test kashi perform keleli ahe second method ni. Kutli second method hai? Dilution method. Okay, prepared water in a 300 ml capacity BOD bottle. The DO concentration of diluted sample at the beginning of the test was 9 milligram per liter and 6 milligram per liter. After 5 days, पहिल्यांदा किती होता तो DO determine केला तर पहिल्या दिवशी तो 9 milligram per liter होता आणि 5 दिवसांनी determine केला तर तो किती होता 6 milligram per liter होता. Temperature constant ठेवलेला आहे 20 degree Celsius. तर आता तुम्हाला काय काढायचं आहे तर BOD काढायचं आहे. काढू शकता BOD? Okay, try at your level within 1 minute. Otherwise, I will tell you. It's a very simple example. for just for the understanding how to find out the BOD. Okay, or sometimes for MCQ type of questions it may ask. Okay, so you, that's why this example is taken for your study. What is given to you? Initial DO is given to you, final DO is given to you, then time period and temperature is given to you, 5 day 20 degree Celsius, sample quantity is given to you, and how much is diluted, that is also given to you. So you may be remember the formula to find out the dilution factor. First you should find out the dilution factor. What is the formula to determine the dilution factor? Dilution factor can be determined as dilution ratio or dilution factor is equal to volume of diluted sample upon volume of undiluted sample. Volume of diluted sample kiti hai apna 300 ml hai ani volume of undiluted sample kiti hai 6 ml hai barabar hai 300 upon 5 ml hai 300 upon 5 is equal to 60 barabar. Now we can find out the DOD, simply loss of dissolved oxygen first you need to find out, or we can say oxygen consumed. Barabar hai apna BOD karacha formula kya hai? BOD 5 is equal to oxygen consumed into dilution ratio. The dilution ratio upon varti kadlela hai to 30 ala, 30 jala na 60 ala, sorry. आणि मग आता ऑक्सिजन कंज्यूम्ड करायचं किंवा लॉस ऑफ डीओ काढायचा, त्याच्यासाठी काय करायचं? ऑक्सिजन कंज्यूम्डसाठी पहिल्या दिवशीचा डिझॉल्व्ह ऑक्सिजन दॅट इज गिव्हन टू यू 9 मिलीग्राम पर लिटर, आणि फायनल डेचा डिझॉल्व्ह ऑक्सिजन दॅट इज गिव्हन टू यू 3 मिलीग्राम पर लिटर, सॉरी 6 मिलीग्राम पर लिटर. सो डिफरन्स बिटवीन दीज टू इज द 3 मिलीग्राम पर लिटर. आता हा डीओ निघाला, मग बीओडी फाईलचं फॉर्म्युला काय? ऑक्सिजन कंज्यूम्ड इंटू डायल्युशन रेशो. ऑक्सिजन किती कंज्यूम झालेला आहे? 3 ml, 3 मिलीग्राम पर लिटर, आणि डायल्युशन रेशो किती आला आपला? तर 60. सो यू विल गेट द आन्सर फॉर द बीओडी 5 ऑफ रॉ सीवेज इज 180 मिलीग्राम पर लिटर. आय होप यू अंडरस्टूड, इट्स अ व्हेरी सिंपल एक्झाम्पल. शॅल वी गो फॉर द अनदर वन एक्झाम्पल? काही शंका असेल तर इथं विचारा, नसेल तर आपण पुढच्या एक्झाम्पल सॉल्व्ह करायला जाऊया. मी पार्टिसिपेंट बॉक्स बघत बसते तुम्ही शंका विचारापर्यंत. एक मिनिट देते मी तुम्हाला शंका विचारायला. तुम्ही मेसेज बॉक्स मध्ये टाकू शकता किंवा डायरेक्ट अनम्यूट करून विचारू शकता. इफ नो प्रॉब्लेम आय विल प्रोसीड विद इन 1 मिनिट. Shall I go to the next point? Next example. Okay, write down next example. Determine ultimate BOD for a sewage having 5 day BOD at 20 degree Celsius as 160 ppm. Assume the deoxygenation constant as 0.2 per day. Deoxygenation rate constant to the base 10 or to the base E kahi asel tar to kashamadhe measure kela jato per day. Or day inverse you can write down. Determine the ultimate BOD. काय काढायचंय तुम्हाला? Ultimate BOD for a raw sewage, for a raw sewage having 5 day BOD at 20 degree Celsius, having 5 day BOD at 20 degree Celsius as 160 ppm. 5 दिवसाचा BOD किती आहे त्याचा? त्या सॅम्पलचा 160 ppm आहे, आणि त्याचं तुम्हाला काय काढायचंय? तर अल्टिमेट BOD काढायचं आहे. Assume the deoxygenation constant as 0.2 per day. Now you can solve this example. Note down whatever is given to you. Given is BOD5, or we can say it is a Y5 given to you as a 160 ppm. Then second one is given to you, temperature of sewage, it is 20 degrees Celsius. And deoxygenation constant is given to you 0.2 per kg, sorry, per day. Okay, last 10 minutes are there. So we may solve only this example, and one more or two more examples I will take in the next lecture. Okay. So solve this example. Now BOD 5U is given to you. Y5U is equal to L naught minus L5U. That relation we are knowing. Okay. So we will rewrite that relation. L naught into the bracket 1 minus 10 raised to minus 5U K. The BOD 5U kiti dilele aahe tumhala 160 ppm dilele aahe. So I will write that 160 ppm here, and then K value of K is also given to you as a 0.2 day inverse or per day value is given to you. Then BOD 5U 160 is equal to L naught into bracket 1 minus 5U into pKh value kiti aahe tumchi 0.2 per day. So value of that K is taken here 0.2 per day. Okay. Then next one. We can go for the next point, that 160 is equal to L naught into bracket. That's a calculation keela 0.7488. Kiwa L naught finally tumhala kiti milto 213.7 ppm. That is nothing but the ultimate BOD. That is nothing but the ultimate BOD. Getting? So ultimate BOD of a given sample is 213.7 ppm. Okay. Now we'll solve one more example. हे जर तुमचं लिहून झालं असेल असं होप करते किंवा एक मिनिट देते आणि त्याच्यानंतर मग पुढचं एक्झाम्पल घेऊया आपण. वन वे टीचिंग इज व्हेरी डिफिकल्ट जॉब, स्टील वी आर डुईंग, बट यू आर नॉट अंडरस्टँडिंग अवर पेन्स अँड यू आर नॉट पेईंग अटेन्शन मोर. एम आय राईट? May I go to the next point? Richa, share काय झाली? Richa file झाली का? बरोबर आहे की? So BOD is given to you. 160 is equal to L naught into bracket 1 minus 10 raised to minus 5U into 0.2 is the value of K. Then from that we calculated dissolved oxygen. That is 213. Sorry, L naught is equal to 213.7 ppm, or we can say it is a milligram per liter. It is organic matter, so we can measure in this equation. Okay, now write down one more example. The BOD of raw sewage incubated for one day at 30 degrees Celsius have been found to be 100 milligram per liter. What will be the 5-day BOD at 20 degrees Celsius BOD? At assume K is equal to 0.12 at 20 degrees Celsius. काय काय दिलेलं आहे तुम्हाला? लिहून झालं का एक्झाम्पल? The BOD of a sewage incubated for one day. किती दिवसासाठी? One day. म्हणजे BOD 1 दिलेला आहे तुम्हाला. बरोबर आहे? BOD 1 डिटरमाइन करायचं किंवा केलेला आहे. One day at 30 degree Celsius. Temperature किती ठेवलं होतं? 30 degree Celsius. Is that temperature is standard? K value of K is the 2 we have taken for 20 degree Celsius. Here for the 30 degree Celsius we need to determine it. Has been found to be 100 milligram per liter. BOD 1 at 30 degree Celsius किती आहे तुमचा? 100 milligram per liter. What will be the 5-day BOD? What will be the 5-day 20 degree Celsius BOD? जर तो पहिल्या दिवसाचा एक दिवसाचा BOD 30 degree Celsius ला 100 milligram per liter असेल तर तो पाचव्या दिवशी 20 degree Celsius temperature ला किती असेल? Assume K is equal to 0.12 at a 20 degree Celsius. At a 20 degree Celsius, K value काय सांगितलेले आहे? 0.12. Okay. then you can solve example. You can note down the given data. Y1, that is nothing but VOD1 is given to you 100 milligram per liter at 30 degree Celsius. You should note down that temperature issue. Okay. And K20 is given to you 0.12. Okay. At 20 degree Celsius. K is the rate constant at 20 degree Celsius is given to you 0.12. Now first find K30. आता तुम्हाला K20 माहिती आहे आणि K30 काढावा लागेल. So what is the relation to determine the value of K at different temperature? That relation I have mentioned here in a box. So note down you also please. KT is equal to K20 into theta raised to T minus 20. And जर हे पण कधी शक्य असतं की ह्या इक्वेशनने तुम्ही काढणं तर एका ठराविक रेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचरला. Is it? So KT is equal to K20 into theta raised to T minus 20. Now theta, value of theta, how to take the value of theta? That 1.056 at 20 degree Celsius to 30 degree Celsius is available. Okay, so we are interested in a 20 to 30 degree Celsius. So we will take the value of theta as a 1.056. So we will rewrite this equation. KT is equal to, KT manje kay? K30 kadayche aplyala, barobar hai? K30 is equal to K20 into bracket. And the value of theta is 1.056 raised to T minus 20. So, versus T ahe, again temperature ahe. So, that temperature value is 30. 30 minus 20. Okay. So, we can rewrite this equation and write as a K30 is equal to 0.12. K20 chi value kiti hai? 0.12 into bracket 1.056 raised to 10. 1.056 is the into raised to 10. Barabar hai? Is a leakage value, or we can solve further and we will get as a 0.207 per day. 0.207 per day. Now, YT. Ata kasa sa sala ki ha Y1 cha kadla. Y1 tar tumhara mahit hota barabar hai. Y1 100 milligram per liter. आता के टी माहित होता 0.12. आता के 30 माहित झाला तुम्ही कॅल्क्युलेट केला 0.207. बरोबर आहे. आता वाय 30 काढूया आपण. वाय 30 इज इक्वल टू एल नॉट इंटू ब्रॅकेट 1 - 10⁻⁻ⁿ - K30 इंटू टी. आता के 30 ची व्हॅल्यू वी डिटरमाइन 0.207. ओके. सो 100 इज इक्वल टू के वाय टी ची व्हॅल्यू किती आहे 100. 100 इज इक्वल टू एल नॉट into bracket 1 - 10⁻⁷ - 0207 into 1. 1 is the time at time t is equal to 1. How yt 1 kadto, yt 1 ghetoy apan, mhanunach value of yt kiti ghetli apan 100. Tithe varti dilele chhe aplyala example madhe. Into bracket l not into bracket 1 - 10⁻⁷ - 0.207 into 1 as t time is equal to 1 we have. From that you can find out the ultimate VOD, that is L naught is equal to 263.8 milligram per liter. 263.8 milligram per liter. Okay, have you noted down this part? So about to end the time, and you may have another lecture. So we will stop here, and once again we will solve this example. Time being, you just note down. Okay, friends, have a nice day ahead. Take care, be safe at your home. Don't go anywhere, as Pandharpur is raising the COVID-19 cases very fast, rapidly it is increasing. Yesterday till night, that cases was 21. And this is the time where we should take care now. Is it? So I express thanks to you for attending.